It is hard to be proud to be a Member of Parliament when, as a body, we are all tarnished with the Government's brush. When, in the eyes of the public, we are tainted by allegations of sleaze. The Government's actions last Wednesday have rightly been condemned across the board.
When I was first elected to this House, the mother of all parliaments, I was incredibly proud because I thought that members conducted themselves with honour and integrity, that we were not ruled by a Prime Minister who was a tin pot dictator and who is himself is now mired in sleaze.
Order. We've just said we want to show the House that it's best. Tin pot dictator aimed at an individual, I don't think is going to bring unity.
We are still in a bit of a hole, the whole of Parliament. We still have a motion that was carried last week, which leaves the question of Mr Paterson's conduct hanging in the air. I gave earlier today a draft of a motion which could be considered by the House tomorrow if the Government were to table it tonight, and I think it would have the support of the whole House in clearing up the fact, as you, Mr Speaker, referred to, that we haven't actually decided whether Mr Paterson's behaviour was inappropriate. I think the whole House now accepts that it was.
Mr Paterson has now resigned, so it would not be possible for the House to endorse a sanction of suspension. And I simply remind the House that he suffered a serious personal tragedy. He has now resigned. In his statement, he said he wants to continue outside of public life in terms of politics. And therefore, I think we should respect that.
When the Prime Minister gives the green light to corruption, he corrodes that trust. When he says that the rules to stop vested interests don't apply to his friends, he corrodes that trust. And when he deliberately undermines those charged with stopping corruption, he corrodes that trust.